Hey everyone. So I wanted to talk about Taylor Momsen and explore the possible reasons why she still smokes. And maybe why she even started smoking in the first place. Now, I don't think Taylor Momsen's ever going to see this video, but I hope that somebody out there sees this video who smokes. Maybe a smoker would watch this and maybe somehow in some weird way they could be influenced to stop smoking from this video. Now, why am I talking about Taylor Momsen in particular is because I'm a fan of Taylor Momsen. I like her band, The Pretty Reckless. I think she's very, very talented. And it's a bit mind-boggling. I like to think, okay, first of all, I like to think that Taylor Momsen wants to live forever. I just like to think that. Do I have evidence for this? Not really. In fact, I have a lot of evidence to the contrary, because she's a freaking smoker, apparently. Sometimes I even like to think, well, maybe she's just faking smoking. Could these be fake cigarettes? Do we know that these are real cigarettes? You know, I know that's very conspiratorial, but I'm just a conspiratorial type of person. So, you know, crossing my fingers, maybe she's like, these are real cigarettes, but like it's not like bad cigarettes. Like, what if she's smoking something else here that's like not bad for you? It's possible, right? Like, I like to keep my mind open to all the possibilities. So what if Taylor Momsen knows some other kind of herb, some other kind of thing to smoke that's actually good for you? What if she knows something that we don't? And what if she's smoking like an herb that promotes longevity? Could this be the case? Maybe. I just have a hard time believing that Taylor Momsen is ignorant about the negative health impact of smoking. Like, she has to know that smoking normal tobacco cigarettes is bad for you, right? Now let's get into some of the reasons maybe why she's a smoker. First of all, I have heard that even tobacco as an herb can have certain health benefits. Okay, like, if it's pure tobacco, tobacco is an herb that's been used in ancient, you know, traditional medicine for a long time. Indians use tobacco. It's supposed to actually cure parasites. It's supposed to rid the body of parasites. It's anti-parasitic. So maybe somewhere along the line, Taylor Momsen picked up a parasite or, you know, some kind of STD or something. And then as a natural reaction to that, she started to crave tobacco. I bet you anything that a lot of people who crave tobacco actually had a parasite or, you know, some kind of STD. Their body's wanting tobacco now to kind of fight, to kind of enhance the immune system. Now, I don't think this is the best option, right? But it's possible. Just throwing that out there that maybe even tobacco itself has its purpose and its use. So there's a few reasons Taylor Momsen might have started smoking. Maybe it's just because she wanted to be cool. Like, it's a rebellious, edgy thing to do. Maybe it was peer pressure. You know, her friends were saying, hey, smoke this. And then before I know it, she's addicted. And now it's just an addiction. She can't stop. Or I think a probable, like, it could be just for her image. Okay, like, she's this rock star. And so to promote her rock star image, she wanted to smoke because it makes her look cooler. And it makes her, you know, come across more like a hardcore rock chick or something. That's a possibility. It's also possible that, I heard that Taylor Momsen was really into, like, music as a young girl. And she got turned on to the Beatles. And now the Beatles are her favorite band. Her dad was, like, a big fan of the Beatles and all these kind of rock bands. And so it could just be, like, this influence as a young girl, like, being exposed to all these bands and, you know, a lot of these lead singers of these bands, the Beatles, they're smokers, okay? Like, I think most of the people in the Beatles were smokers. Now, here's another reason I'm thinking. Maybe she started smoking. This is less likely, but maybe she had some kind of abuse as a child. I know that being abused as a child can increase your likelihood of smoking and getting into drugs as a form of self-medication. And this is very common. You know, people who are abused as children, they're more likely to go down a bad path in life where they're smoking and doing drugs because it's just like a way to cope. It's self-medicating. It's smoking is a stress relief for a lot of people. Something about the cigarettes, the tobacco, the nicotine, it helps with anxiety. And Taylor Momsen seems like a pretty anxious type of person. Maybe she has a chemical imbalance. Maybe it's it could be a genetic predisposition. That's another possibility. A lot of people, I think, have a chemical imbalance in their brain. They're just more likely to be the type of people that gravitate towards cigarettes because they're just more anxious, more stressed out. Their brain is not producing the right types of chemicals in the right amount, and so they need to self-medicate with cigarettes to kind of compensate for what their own brain and biology lacks. So that's another possibility. So if you're watching this and you're a smoker, think to yourself, what are the reasons you're smoking? You know, like what is causing you to smoke? Were you abused? Might you have a parasite? Are you self-medicating to deal with some kind of stress in your life? You know, these are the types of questions I hope you're asking yourself. Because honestly, smoking is not good for your health. It's not good for your life. You know, you're going to die more likely. You're going to die from some cancer. And if you do smoke, I would recommend that you at least, at the very least, switch to a brand of cigarettes that has just pure tobacco. Okay, there's this brand. I don't want to promote a brand, but like there's brands of cigarettes out there that don't have all these chemical additives. They're just more pure tobacco. That's much better for you. I'm not endorsing that. I don't think you should smoke at all, but it's a much better option to smoke one of these brands that doesn't have these additives. There's like over 4,000 chemical additives to cigarettes, and that's what's doing most of the damage. It's like that's way more harmful than the tobacco itself. That's something to take into consideration. And from the research I've done, if you do want to quit smoking, a lot of people are finding kratom. Kratom is a herb, and they're finding that kratom is helping them quit smoking. And I'll put links in the description if you want to look into using kratom to help quit smoking. And it does help with withdrawals, and it has some of the same anti-stress effects of tobacco without the negatives of tobacco and nicotine. Kratom is much better for you. And it could even have longevity promoting effects as kratom. So look into that. And what else did I want to talk about? Yeah, I think that pretty much covers it. So if you're going to quit smoking, you're going to need a lot of willpower. You've created this addiction. Your body's now become, you know, dependent on this nicotine. So it's just, you just have to realize that living forever and your health is way more important than, you know, the pleasurable feelings you get from smoking. You have to put your health first. That's what's most important. Addiction is a strong, powerful thing, and it's sad. And I guess this is turning into like a PSA more than anything. But if you want to live forever, and I hope you do want to live forever, whoever's watching this, who's ever listening here, I hope you want to live forever. Living forever is the most important goal. And please quit smoking. Look into other ways that people are quitting. You know, people are doing it. It has been done, okay? You're not the only one that has struggled with this addiction. Do research, figure out how to quit, and you'll be better off for it. And you can actually, hopefully, live forever. So that's it. May you live forever. Living forever is possible. That's it.